Hello everyone and welcome. In today's video, I'll go over WrestleDruid talents, traits and playstyle for Arena. The goals in this video will teach you about positioning and playstyle as a WrestleDruid, which will make it easier to keep your team offensive. WrestleDruid relies on healing over time effects to keep their targets topped. Your top comps at the moment are Turbo, RMD or WMD. What comp you want to play will depend on preference. Turbo is your go-to melee cleave, since it has a lot of burst damage but can also survive till late dampening with off healing and strong defensive cooldowns. RMD is very strong defensively and allows you to play more offensive as a healer by using your Cyclone. This comp is one of the stronger comps to play as a WrestleDruid because of how much CC it has. It's also very strong defensively, but it relies on short burst windows and setups to score a kill. WMD is almost identical to RMD by sacrificing some CC for stable damage by bringing a warrior instead of a rogue. WMD is very strong defensively, since the warrior has a lot of tools to peel for his druid or mage with disarm, fear, stormbolt and constant slows. Your standard talent build will look like this. Soul of the Forest can be swapped out for incarnation versus heavy burst comps, for example versus jungle, to counter incarnation from the feral druid. It's also strong versus rogue mage setups, since it allows you to spam heal without casting and makes you immune to polymorph for the duration. For your PvP talents, Focus Growth should always be picked, since it increases the healing of your Life Bloom and reduces the mana cost. Since it stacks up to 3 times, the healing of Life Bloom is increased by a lot. Revitalize should be used versus melee cleaves, since Rejuvenation will place an extra hold on the target that will proc when getting struck by a critical melee attack. Cyclone can be used in most comps, and can be used both offensively and defensively. Cyclone should not be picked when playing a comp like Turbo Cleave or a melee cleave that focuses on surviving until the enemy team is out of cooldowns. Nourish makes your regrowth apply one of your missing HOTs on the target. If all HOTs are active on the target, regrowth will be a critical heal instead. Nourish should be played instead of Revitalize when facing a spell cleave, or instead of Cyclone when going for a dampening game when playing a melee cleave. The best Azerite trait for WrestleDruid is Growth Tending. This trait should be stacked 3 times, since it will make your Swiftment apply a huge HOT onto the target for 9 seconds, which also counts towards your Mastery to increase your healing. Your playstyle will slightly depend on what comp you play. When playing a melee cleave, you will play more passively and try to secure the game in dampening when the enemy team is out of cooldowns. And when playing a melee caster comp like RMD or WMD, you will play slightly more aggressive with cycloning targets. These playstyle goals apply to nearly every comp, and applying them will help improve your gameplay as a WrestleDruid. Positioning. Positioning and avoiding CC or swaps is your first goal to keep your team offensive. Poor positioning can result in eating more CC or opening yourself up to a swap, which will make you lose the majority of your games. Jumping into this clip, we can see how important positioning is. Minpoike is standing at the pillar trying to avoid both CC and swaps onto him. Playing like this makes it extremely hard for the enemy mage to land CC on him, and it makes it hard for the enemy team to perform a swap. Jumping into the next clip, we can see Minpoike gets caught in a paralyze, and the enemy healer starts moving towards him for a fear. When the enemy healer gets close to him, he uses his Tiger Dash to cross to another pillar before getting caught in a CC chain. In this clip, the enemy team is looking for an aggressive opener, Minpoike. His positioning at the pillar allows his partners to slow the enemy DPS, and he can land a Cyclone on the enemy warrior and completely stop their opener. Try to position yourself at the pillar as much as possible, since it will make it harder for the enemy team to land CC or swaps onto you. In the clips shown before, if Minpoike decided to leave the pillar, he would have most likely got swapped to, or get caught in a CC chain while the enemy team kills one of his DPS. Don't fall behind. Once you fall behind in healing as a WrestleDruid, it can be really hard to top your targets back up, since WrestleDruid has less burst healing than most other healers. Your second goal is to avoid this. Keep your HOTs active on your targets while remembering goal 1. If you don't have your HOTs active on a target when it gets swapped to, you will have to apply your HOTs before you can start healing them back up. This alone can be enough to make you fall behind in healing. Use cooldowns like Iron Bark to keep the target on stable health during cooldowns from the enemy team before they drop to low health. This will make it easier to keep your team topped through it. Jumping into this clip, we can see how Minpoike keeps his HOTs up on both his DPS. This way he can keep them both topped, but also quickly heal them back up if the enemy team swaps target. Jumping into the next clip, we can see another top WrestleDruid, Looney, also keeping both targets fully HOTed. In the next clip, we can see the enemy Monk uses his Touch of Death. Minpoika decides to use his Iron Bark to counter the damage from Touch of Death, which allows him to keep his DPS on stable health and top them back up quickly after that. In the clip shown before, by keeping HOTS active on both targets and using Iron Bark before their DPS drop to low health, both Minpoika and Looney can keep them aggressive. Try to have your HOTS active at all times and avoid as much damage as possible to keep your team stable. Once you fall behind in healing, it won't be easy to top your team back up and you will most likely have to call them back to the pillar. Keep 3 stacks of Life Bloom up. Your third goal is to keep 3 stacks of Life Bloom active on one member of your team. Generally, you want to keep 3 stacks of Life Bloom on a target that's the most squishy and who's likely to get trained. Some teams swap target a lot. This means you will have to swap your Life Bloom stacks accordingly to the target that's in the most danger. For example, when playing RMD, if your mage has 2 ice blocks, but your rogue has no trinket, evasion or cloak, you could consider putting the Life Bloom stacks on your rogue instead. Before we jump into the next clips, remember that you can refresh your Life Bloom stacks and still get the bloom effect from them when it has 5 seconds or less remaining. This is actually a fairly big instant heal that a lot of people forget about. Jumping into this clip, we can see how Looney keeps up 3 stacks of Life Bloom on his most squishy target. Jumping back to the clip shown before, we can see Minpoika also keeping 3 stacks of Life Bloom active on his most squishy DPS. In the next clip, Looney uses his Iron Bark when coming out of a bash. He gets trapped after, and he's struggling to keep his team topped. He swaps his Life Bloom stacks to the Rogue, because there aren't any dots on his other DPS, which means they will train down his Rogue, and he's now the most squishy target on the team. Make sure that you have 3 stacks of Life Bloom active on the target as much as you can. When the enemy team forces cooldowns, or trains your other DPS, make sure you swap the Life Bloom stacks to the DPS that has no cooldowns left, or the one that's being trained. Use CC when your team has pressure. When your team has pressure, you can push in and start assisting them with CC, either by bashing a target, using Cyclone to extend CC chains, or using Cyclone to clone a low target while waiting for DR to reset, or when the target uses a big defensive cooldown like Touch of Karma from Monk, Astral Shift from Shaman, or Barkskin from another Druid. Jumping into the clip, we can see the enemy Hunter is under pressure. The enemy Feral is sapped, and the priest is in a hex. This means Looney can push in and easily land a Cyclone on the healer without having to worry about positioning. Jumping towards the end of the game, we can see the enemy Feral is under a lot of pressure and Looney decides to Cyclone him on low health and set up a CC chain on the healer meanwhile. Looney lands a bash on the enemy healer and this secures them the game. In the next clip, we can see how you can use Cyclone offensively to CC a target with low health and a big cooldown active. Minpoika and his team swap to the enemy Druid, and he uses his Barkskin and Trinket to survive the setup. Since the enemy Druid is still on low health, Minpoika Cyclones him to keep him on low health while waiting for the DRs to reset. Knowing when to leave the pillar is important. If you run into the open to land CC too early, it could result in the enemy team forcing cooldowns from you instead. Leave the pillar just after coming out of CC, or when your team has a bunch of cooldowns left and the enemy team is completely out of cooldowns. Use CC to relieve pressure. Cyclone, Bash and Entangling Roots can also be used defensively to CC targets with burst abilities active. This can help relieve pressure from your team and allows them to find an opening to start a CC chain. Jumping into the next clip, we can see Looney's team is under a lot of pressure. He lands a Cyclone on the enemy Hunter, and by doing this he creates some breathing room for himself to top his team back up. In the next clip, we can see how Looney uses his CC to relieve pressure from his team. He uses Entangling Roots to root the warrior, followed up by a Cyclone to stop the warrior from doing any damage. Jumping forwards into the clip, we can see the enemy Paladin has his wings active. Looney uses his Cyclone to stop the Paladin from doing any damage while he has his biggest cooldown active. This way, he can keep his team topped without having to heal through the damage. When your team is under pressure, make sure you CC the enemy team during burst windows, since trying to stop their damage is more efficient than trying to just outheal it. If the enemy team ends up using a trinket or big cooldown like Divine Shield to get rid of the CC, it will open up another swap opportunity. That's gonna be it for this guide, guys. Please leave a plus kill if you enjoyed it and let me know what you think in the comments. And I'll see you guys next time.